resources, inspiring interviews, business practices, and practical advice to take your art career to the next level. Join Sergio Gomez and today's Artist Next Level and get ready to take control of your career.
Hello, my next level friends. Welcome to another episode of the Artist Next Level podcast. Well, today I don't have a guest. Instead, what I want to do is I want to share with you one of my newest things I'm doing, which is called Breakfast with Sergio. This is a brand new live video that I do Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, 7:30, 7:45 a.m. or so, Chicago time. So if you want to join me for breakfast, just join me at Facebook or Instagram or in YouTube. And today, I want to share with you one of the latest episodes of Breakfast with Sergio. Enjoy. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Breakfast with Sergio. This is episode number 8. And today, I want to talk about how to grow an audience. So this is episode number 8. And I'm going to talk about how to grow an audience for your art or for whatever else that you might want to create an audience for. So thanks for watching me. Thanks for being here with me, for joining me for breakfast today. Breakfast here, delicious. I'll tell you what I have here today. On my breakfast, on my plate, it's a tortilla which is lightly fried on the pan, and then I have some spinach. So then there's another, here you go, see a little closer. There's another layer of spinach over it, and then egg white with a little bit of guacamole sauce on top of it. Very good, smells great. This is what I'll be having for breakfast today. Beautiful day here in Chicago. Nice and sunny today. Really, really, really cool here in the Chicagoland area, Midwest area. It's pretty, pretty nice looking today. So my friends, I want to talk about building an audience. How do you build an audience for your artist? Specifically, if you're an artist or if you're a creative, you know, that's a topic that is very important to us because we all like to have an audience for the things that we do as well, right? So again, welcome to Breakfast with Sergio. So excited that you are joining me today. Well, this was a pretty awesome weekend. It was a pretty busy weekend. I had the opportunity to speak to high school students at various venues. So it all started Friday at South Suburban College, where I had a few minutes to talk to about 500 high school kids. So I walk into the stage, and I'm in front of on this big auditorium with 500 kids in front of me, you know, thinking out, how do I start this thing, right? Then Sunday, the same thing. Sunday at the Joby Art Center, we had another big event. Hundreds of high school kids with their parents were there. They call my name, I walk into the stage, and the same thing, right? How do I start this thing? And then same day, Sunday after that, I go to the Bridgeport Art Center, also in Chicago, where there's another group of, again, 300-500 kids with their parents, and they call up my name again, and it's the same thing, right? How do I start this thing, you know? So it's all about, and I was thinking about this, you know, this is the same thing in our art career, right? It's all about attention. It's all about attention and grabbing attention, right? So the first thing I do when I get up on stage, whether I'm speaking to hundreds or just five people, is I have to grab their attention. Just because I'm at the stage, it doesn't mean that they're actually paying attention. It doesn't mean that their mind is actually there. They could be daydreaming. They could be thinking about something else. So the first thing I got to do is call up their attention. And attention is something that we all are after, especially if you're an artist. You know, you are after attention. If you are in social media, it's because you are after attention too. You know, nobody joins social media to be the only one there, right? You join because there's other people there that you can connect to, that you can also be part of that community. And that's what social media does. It gives us a platform where you can be there and you can also call attention. And attention is not so bad. You know, sometimes you think, well, that sounds very selfish. You know, you're calling attention to yourself. But, you know, attention is not so bad. It all depends what you do with that attention, I think, that matters. So if you want to grow an audience, well, the first thing you got to do is you got to call, you got to go for the attention, right? It's an attention battle. And the nice thing is when you're in a stage talking to a lot of people, well, you are the only one in the stage. But otherwise, you know, when you are in social media or any other outlet, you know, it's everybody's calling for attention and trying to grab attention. But once you grab the attention of the viewer, whether with your post, with your picture, with whatever
you are delivering is also what are you going to do with that attention? And that's what makes the difference between, you know, people wanting to follow you and wanted to know more about what you do or not. You know, it's what you deliver once you get the person's attention. And I think you have to deliver value and positivity. You know, that's one of the two things that I'm all about, that I love to do when I'm, you know, looking to grab somebody's attention, is to then deliver something positive or deliver something of value. You know, here's an example. The breakfast with Sergio is not just about the breakfast here that I'm going to eat just in a few minutes, but it's about also what I'm going to do with the attention that you are giving me every morning when I do breakfast with Sergio. So I am very conscious in my mind of, I have your attention here for a few minutes, I better deliver something of value to you. Otherwise, this experience will be a whole waste of your time. And I don't want that to happen, because I want you to keep coming back for more breakfast with Sergio. So that's how you build an audience. You not only have to grab the attention of the viewer, of the person on the other side, but you have to deliver something of value. You have to deliver some positivity as well. Unfortunately, in social media, we see a lot of negativity, and probably you can agree with me where there's some people who use their attention just to give negativity and just complain or just hateful things. And so who wants to follow people like that? Well, other people that think the same, that are the same, will follow that kind of person, right? But if you want to really build an audience, you got to think about, you know, positivity, value that you are providing as well, and interest that you are providing, because that's how you build fans. Now, there's a difference between fans and followers. A lot of people get caught up with the numbers. You know, we think that, okay, I want to build an audience for my art, I need 100,000 followers. Well, there's a difference between a fan and a follower, right? A follower, somebody who just follows you, clicks and the follow, might click on a like here and there, but it really doesn't care much about what you do. It may be because it was popular, or maybe they saw something they liked, but it's not, you know, exactly somebody who's really there for you. However, a fan is somebody who loves what you do. It's the person who will miss it when you stop doing what you are doing. That's what you're looking for. And I would rather have 10 fans than 1,000 followers. And that is true, because those 10 fans will send me a message, hey, haven't heard from you, haven't seen breakfast with Sergio. Those are the ones that will send me a message, you know, what you said this morning was really awesome, it really helped me in my day. Those are the ones that you're looking for. So as an artist, you are also looking for people who respond to your art. Not only that they click a like here once every 3 months, but that they really help you in your art, who support your art. Maybe some of them maybe become buyers of your work. Maybe some of them will become great fans, in which they'll go to your openings, they'll attend your shows, they'll comment on your posts. You know, those are the people that you're looking for. And you do not need hundreds of thousands of them, right? You gotta build an audience, I believe, thinking about the long term. You gotta think about the long term. Everything I do is thinking about the long term. This breakfast with Sergio, which started just as a little experiment, it really, I'm thinking about long term, how this can grow in the long term. I'm thinking about breakfast with Sergio 5 years from now, 10 years from now, how this might look like. When I started my podcast 3 years ago, you know, I had no audience. Nobody was listening to it. I was just making episodes every week, and maybe my brother and a couple other people were listening to it, but that's about it. You know, I wasn't looking for overnight audience for it. Now, you know, 3 years after, when I look at the statistics, thousands of artists download my podcast from around the world, and it's just mind-blowing to me, you know, artists from in Australia and Russia and the Middle East, everywhere, you know, that downloading the podcast. That didn't happen overnight. And that's how you want to build an audience. You want to build an audience at your pace, slowly, looking for people that really care for you, not just numbers. Numbers are important, don't get me wrong. You know, I think numbers are important. However, you want to build an audience of people who really care for what you do. And the way you do it is you grab people's attention, and once you have their attention, then you deliver something of value, you deliver positivity, and I think that's what makes the difference. when you are building your audience, when you're building an audience for your art or an audience for whatever you do as a creative person or whatever you do as well, you know, that's how you do it. And, you know, that's something I think about every time I walk on a stage to deliver a talk, whether it's a 5-minute talk or it's a half hour. You know, this weekend, as I did that with these audiences on Friday and Sunday, I probably spoke to over 1,000 people over this weekend in all three combined. And it was all about, you know, how do I get the people attention and what can I deliver that is of value to them and that so that they will enjoy this attention that they are getting from me. So that's something that you want to think about. I hope this was of value to you. I really thank you for your attention to Breakfast with Sergio, for spending 10 minutes with me here for breakfast. It really means a lot to me. It's something that I really, really value. And I hope to, every time I do this, to provide some nuggets, some value to you so that you can keep coming back to Breakfast with Sergio and that you can also keep sharing it with your friends as well. So thanks for watching. I'm going to now put my full attention into this delicious breakfast that I made. If you want to know what I made, if you came a little late, just go back and watch the replay as well. And speaking of attention, this is something really cool before I go that I found out over the weekend. On Friday, as I was participating at South Suburban College with the high school kids that we had, all the art kids that came, about 500 of them, one of the teachers in one school, Mr. Ryan Evans, said, you know what, when you do Breakfast with Sergio and we are in art class, we listen to it. So that is an awesome thing. I want to give a shout out to all the students from Mr. Evans for, you know, listening to Breakfast with Sergio at their school. That is super good. You know what that makes me think? That makes me think of, well, I have to deliver, you know, when I do this, because it's not just not for fun. It's I want to deliver value to you if you're a high school student or if you are an established artist with years and years of experience. And that's what it's all about, my friends. I want to thank you for listening as well. Actually, this t-shirt that I'm wearing today, this shirt, was given to me by also one of the high schools over the weekend. And that is pretty awesome. You know, I wear it with pride. It's so cool. I really appreciate what you guys do. And if you are in YouTube, just subscribe to my channel so that you can get all the episodes. And if you are in Instagram or in Facebook, you know, make some comments. Or also YouTube, you know, make some comments. What do you think about attention? How do you see attention? How can you deliver value as an artist also to your audience? And don't forget the difference between a fan and a follower, right? You want to keep looking for fans that really care for what you do as an artist, as a person. Those are the people that will miss you when you stop doing what you do. So keep looking for those. It takes time to build it, but they come if you do the right thing. So keep giving positivity. That's the best thing you can do today. Thanks, everybody. I will see you in the next time on Wednesday for Breakfast with Sergio. Take care. Have a good rest of your day.
Check out our website at www.theartistnextlevel.com, where you will find our podcast library, learn about our upcoming webinars, find resources relevant to your career, and much more. Thanks for listening to today's podcast, and we'll see you at the next level.